my soul. O Lord, my God, you are very great.
You are clothed with honor and majesty, wrapped in light as with a garment.
You stretch out the heavens like a tent. You set the beams of your chambers on the waters. You make the clouds your chariot. You ride on the wings of the wind. You make the winds your messengers, fire and flame your ministers.
You set the earth on its foundations, so it shall never be shaken.
You cause the grass to grow for the cattle, and plants for people to use, to bring forth food from the earth, and wine to gladden the human heart, oil to make the face shine, and bread to strengthen the human heart.
You have made the moon to mark the seasons. The sun knows its time for setting.
You make the darkness and its night, when the animals of the forest come creeping out. The young lions roar for their prey, seeking their food from God.
When the sun rises, they withdraw and lie down in their dens. People go out to their work and to their labor until evening.
O Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
We will sing to the Lord as long as we live. We will sing our praise to our God while we have being. May our meditations be pleasing to God, for we rejoice in the Lord.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the waters.
Then God said,
"Let there be light."
And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness.
And God said,
"Let the waters under the sky be gathered together in one place, and let the dry land appear."
And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good.
Then God said,
"Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seeds, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it."
And it was so.
And God said,
"Let the earth bring forth the living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of the earth of every kind."
And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good.
Then God said,
"Let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth."
So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, God created them. God saw everything that had been made, and indeed, it was very good.
In God's hand is the life of every living thing, and the breath of every human being.
Sings and runs.